Hey there, folks, and welcome back for another video. I'm your host, CDB, or Chris, and thanks so much for joining us again, or if it's your first time, thanks so much for coming to the channel. We have a special shave today, at least in my view, it's special, using old school RazoRock XXX. This is the UFO tub, which is legendary. As you can see, I still have quite a bit in here because I use it sparingly. This soap is probably 6-7 years old, at least 6 years old. Still extremely fragrant because I've never lathered on it. I just scoop some out. And again, it's special, so I use it sparingly. The scent on this is that Aqua de Parma type scent. I'm not going to show you the ingredients of this soap because you can't get this version anymore. This is the first version that came out. It is terrific. It's just one of those soaps that I love. It's one of my favorite soaps. We're going to be using the RazoRock Hawk, version 2. And this is for, I already forgot his name. That's not my name. Sorry. It's funny. It's ironic that I would forget a guy's name that is, that's not my name. Anyway, let's slap on some water here. And we're using the RazoRock. This is all RazoRock today. RazoRock pre-shave. And I was watching a channel today, a channel that I like called Shave Cave. And the gentleman used some pre-shave. And then he sort of went to the sink and sort of lathered it up a little bit. So we're going to do that just to see what happens. And of course, I'm not lathering it as well as he did. But we're just going to, you know, activate it, as he said. I like Shave Cave channel, newer channel, I think. But anyway, seemed to be a nice guy, a lot of good energy. And so Shave Cave, if you happen to see this, great job. I appreciate your channel. I've been trying to check out a lot of channels, both new and old. Let's get started lathering while we're blabbing here. Anyway, I was checking out Shave Cave and then SoCal Shave and Enrique Suave. Remember that song, Rico Suave? Rico Suave. Remember that? And so I watched one of his videos, which was his 5-4-3-2-1. And I responded with a comment, Enrico Suave. Sorry, I can't roll my R's proper. But anyway, Enrico had replied that it was an honor for me to watch his content. The pleasure is mine, guys. I mean, you guys bringing fresh blood, fresh energy. If it weren't for new people who were bringing other people along, we wouldn't have anyone to participate, you know, because all the old guys eventually die off, you know. I hate to say that, but I mean, they either fall out of love with the hobby or a lot of people, you know, get old, they pass on. I don't mean literally, obviously, we don't want anyone to pass, but fresh blood is absolutely necessary to sustain this hobby. So all these folks, like the ones I've been mentioning, I'm going to start featuring new channels and old channels and talk about them because it's really important that we spread the word. One of the things I learned during my supermarket runs, if you haven't seen those videos, go watch them, called Supermarket Shave and then the Hunt for Gear in Charleston, West Virginia. One of the things I learned is if we have to depend on department stores and things for gear, we're in trouble. So we better evangelize for this hobby and support the artisans. And by the way, that's my name, Light Razor here. The blade, by the way, is Feather Professional Super. So this is their most aggressive blade. Really lightweight. Let's get back to what I was saying and then we'll talk about the shave as it goes. Uses Artist Club blades, by the way. It's really important that we evangelize for the hobby and that we support the artisans that we do business with and love. Because without them, we'd be in bad shape. We do only have Amazon, and Amazon has a lot of stuff, but it's not enough. So one of the things that the supermarket experience opened my eyes to is the fact that without these artisans who, you know, I've been rough on at times, you know, let's be honest, but without those folks, we wouldn't have any gear. You know, they're out there innovating. They're taking all the risks. So those of us who are so-called reviewers really aren't taking a lot of risk. But we are putting in the effort. We're, you know, buying products. I mean, we're doing our part to evangelize. But these artisans and these vendors are taking a tremendous amount of risk to bring us these great products. So we need to be supportive. Now, that said, that doesn't mean you have to like everything they do and everything they produce. We don't have to like it when they raise prices, but you know, a lot of us are still gonna buy things anyway, let's face it. But I mean, it's okay to voice displeasure. But the one thing we don't wanna do is run them out of business so we have no gear. You know, this is important. Gear, this is a gear-driven hobby, you know? And so, anyway, the point I wanna get across is really important to appreciate and be supportive of our vendors and also, you know, the folks who are doing the work evangelizing for the hobby, the new people, the old people, everybody who are doing their part in a positive way. It, for me, it's important to do things in a positive way. And that's, you know, that's the way I want to do it. I have not always been this way, obviously. You know, Chris from A Cut Above just made a comment on one of my videos today where he was like, hey, essentially, he said, I was gone for a while. And reading between the lines, he was saying, I wasn't digging the content because, you know, I got into the political stuff and ranting and really just not enjoying myself. And it was obvious. Now, I was going through a rough patch in my life. And I think I used the channel as a way to sort of let steam off. But a lot of people aren't watching these videos to hear people rant and let steam off. You know, they want to hear about the gear. They want to hear about things that are, you know, positive and uplifting. And you can still not like a product, but produce positive content that's helpful to people. And so what I've learned recently through watching, particularly some of these newer channels, is it's easier just get back to making content that I love, fun, having fun, not immersing myself in politics that are negative. And so anyway, that's the reason for the change. I'm just enjoying myself. And for a time, probably a year or two, I wasn't enjoying myself. And I shouldn't have made content during that time, to be very honest with you. But I'm so fortunate that many of you stuck around and new people have come along. And this is what we intend the channel to be. Having fun, doing shaving content, and doing things that I enjoy, and not so much focusing on things that I don't find enjoyable, which are political stuff that really gets on your nerves and is divisive, you know. So anyway, there's the explanation. Let's get back to talking about shaving here. And by the way, thank you very much, Chris, for the comment. I really appreciate it. It means a lot. So that's not my name. Aggression on this. Does it reach that third level of Parker variant? It's probably close with the Super Blade. I can't say for sure that it's as aggressive because that's my name wanted, a fairly aggressive single edge razor. And the Hawk, the thing about it is it's lightweight. Now you can change it up and put a heavier handle on it. I have always liked this razor. I like the cost. I like the way it shaved. I would call it maybe approaching medium, all right? But it's not, it's certainly not an aggressive shave. Now, here's where I call on the viewers to give your comments below and help That's Not My Name out and let him know what you think some fairly efficient single edge razors are, because it's important to rely on your knowledge as well, because there's a lot of people out there with a tremendous amount of knowledge. I'm just one fellow who does it on video. But there's a lot of you out there who have been doing it far longer and have more experience. I've done a lot, I've had a lot of experience, but there's plenty of people out there who've been doing it for 10, 20, 50 years. So let's put the word out to those people and let them answer some of these questions that I cannot answer myself, because I certainly don't know it all. I learn every day. Like just today, I was doing something I saw on Shave Cave's channel. So I'm watching new channels, old channels, just trying to get a feel for what people are doing, how things have changed. Because for a time I wasn't participating. I was just putting content out there for people to consume, but I wasn't participating. And what I found is I'm really enjoying the participation and talking to other people and stuff. And that was lost. That was all but lost. And so I feel very grateful to be participating. Boy, this soap smells so good. If you like Acqua di Parma, sadly, this version isn't made anymore. It's the best version that was made, in my opinion. No subsequent versions, for my money, were as good as this one. And that's not a knock on the RazoRock product. This one is just terrific, and it holds it's just special to me. And it is one of my favorite soaps, and it will always be in my top list. And if you're fortunate enough to have it, I hope you love it as much as I do, because I really do. I just think it's terrific. All right, let us do our final pass. So that's not my name. I'm calling it close, maybe, to medium. It is certainly not on the minimum side of mild. Get the Super Blade if you get it. And, you know, really, the bad thing about it is everything is subjective. My feeling on how aggressive something is subjective. You know, there's no real meter. And so I'm relying on the other people in the comments below to give their thoughts on single edge razors that they think are pretty aggressive and so on. So hopefully we'll get some good information there. The people have been very good at sharing information for all of our viewers. So we really appreciate that. I saw today where Ken Surf went over 10,000 viewers, or excuse me, 10,000, 17,000. That is terrific. Congratulations, Ken Surf. He makes really good content. So check that out. Check out his channel. But don't sleep on these new guys. Don't sleep on these new guys. They're very passionate. And again, I'm probably gonna cut that bump I have there, no fault of the razor. Do not sleep on these new people, because they bring passion, new energy, new insight. And I've always enjoyed when new people come in and they're really passionate, because it reminds me of when I first started. I couldn't get enough. And, you know, somewhere along the line, when life had its way of, you know, sort of piling on, I sort of lost my enthusiasm. And as I said before, only recently I found that it can just, if you just keep it to this, it's fun. It's fun. So that's why we do it. That's why we've been doing it all along. There is no other reason. Because it's fun. And we enjoy it. And it's that 15 minutes, 20 minutes maybe of zen, so to speak. And if we're making videos, we get to share our thoughts and feelings with other people and have that camaraderie, which is really terrific. And as I said before, I've made lifelong friends in this hobby. And we don't always agree on every issue. Trust me. We've had a lot of disagreements, but we managed to remain friends. And one final thought today. Folks, there always needs to be a path to redemption. Don't hold grudges forever. That's one of the things that is sometimes difficult for me. You don't want to... The worst thing you can ever be is out on a plateau somewhere where there's no redemption and you can't come back, you know. So if you close the book totally on somebody, or if they extend their hand and you turn away, you know, that's a really rough feeling. Because we've all made mistakes, and I have too. I've told you about mine today on this video. So please consider, I'm shaving the wrong way here, look at that. Consider letting down some of those barriers. So hopefully you will do that. And I'm trying to do that myself. So I'm practicing what I'm preaching. And you will see that in some of the products to come soon. So thanks very much. All right. Let us rinse down. We'll come back and we'll start the post. Stay tuned. And we are back with the magic made by witches. Thayer's Witch Hazel. And you see this every day on the channel. You know what it is. You know that I love it, even though it doesn't keep these spots at bay anymore. Sadly, it used to, but it doesn't. Anyhow, let's slap that on the dome and let that set for a moment while we talk about the gear we used. Razor, look at the XXX there. RazoRock Big Bruce is the brush. We use the legendary RazoRock XXX UFO tub. This is the best version, the artisan version of an Acqua di Parma type soap, in my opinion, that was ever made. There are others that are very, very good. Also, Katie's Bubbles made one. Sterling made one. RazoRock has newer versions of it, but this one is very special, at least to me. RazoRock Hawk, single edge razor, uses Artist Club style blades. I'd say far side of mild, meaning towards medium, right? Perhaps close to that medium level. I don't know whether it's going to meet your requirements. That's not my name, I'm sorry. Other people, please chime in below if you've used a super blade with this and let him know what you think about it. We're going to close it out today with a special aftershave. Again, fine XXX made for RazoRock. The best artisan version of this that was ever made. In my opinion, second version, second best would be, my opinion, Piacenza from Sterling. Very, very good also. But this one is special and I don't have much left. I had two bottles. I gave one to Busta. And I think it's one of the few aftershaves he actually kept. And so, because I told him, I said, Busta, when he was doing his fire sale, and he was getting rid of everything, I said, if you're gonna get rid of that, please send it back to me or I'll even pay you for it. And he was like, I'm keeping it. And I'm like, okay. This one is, it's just terrific. Again, Piacenza would be my second pick, but this is terrific. And I don't have much left, so I do kind of use it sparingly. I also have, by the way, I don't use it, but I have it, the XXX bomb. I'm not a bomb guy. I never use bombs, but I have this just because I love that XXX Acqua di Parma scent. I want to thank everyone for joining us today. I hope you'll join us again soon. Until next time, I've been your host, CDB, and I'm saying God bless.